Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. This time it is a long haul, and currently it's about close to 6 a.m. Local time for Beijing, which we are departing from. We've got, as you can see with the Epista crew, we've got about 8 minutes until departure, about a minute, less than a minute until we get our load sheet so we can get things going. At least, of course, simulated. We already know our load sheet by now, but simulated, we got our load sheet so we can enter in our values. And as you can see, it's kind of raining, so we've got weather and terrain as somewhat of a threat, or at least a concern. So we're pretty much ready to go. We're just waiting on some things to finish up for us, and I apologize for the scenery. You can see the jetways are very blue and odd. I'm not sure why that's the case. Thanks.
Talk to you again soon.
But that's just how it's going to be. And, So there's our load sheet. We're going to go ahead and enter in the data now. So we're going to go send a request. 2000. I don't know if that's going to change. We're going to verify these values with our flight plan. Initial cruise should be 3.22. Except, I'm going to have 3.22. So I'm just going to check that. Yes, okay. With that, we're going to go to the EFP, go to performance, copy FMC data, condition is, I'm going to do standing water, we're going to go cancel, and we're going to do condition is wet, runway is 1, wet. Thrust rating, we're going to do takeoff. Takeoff, flap config optimum, AC on, AC, anti-ice off. Winds are 330. 330.
Shall I turn on the APU?
Yes.
Starting APU.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on board today. 8.
And calculate that. And unfortunately, we cannot. Unfortunately, we cannot send that onto the FMC. Thrust limit. Takeoff. Here. Second temperature is 47 degrees. It's 97.5. Here it says 96.6. So 97.5 is better. That's fine. Config only 10. P1s are 144, 171, and 183. It is wet. Acceleration is 3000. 144, 171, 183. And we'll go ahead and put in 183 here. The LNAV MNAV are engaged, they're fine. And that's pretty much complete. Check our progress. Alright, we're good there. Take off. And that's entered. So we could technically show landing data. And we're gonna go to
Hi.
Menu.
The cabin is ready to go.
Thanks, it'll be a short taxi.
Thanks, let me know if you need anything.
Oh, the runway's literally there. That was not planned, it's right next behind us. It's about 200 feet away from us, so that's nice. So I'm just going to verify that our doors are going to close, or our cargo doors. Cockpit to ground. Are we clear to pressurize the hydraulics? Can we pressurize the hydraulics?
Roger, we're clear to pressurize the hydraulics.
Perfect. Doors are closed. That is checked. Before start procedure.
Are we clear to pressurize?
Yes.
Thanks.
Doors are closed. Takeoff trim, we can go ahead and set 6.7 units. That's set for takeoff.
I'm ready for the checklist. Before start checklist. Flight deck door, closed and locked. Passenger signs. Set MCP.
V2183, heading 359, altitude 9,900 feet.
Takeoff speeds.
V1144, VR171, V2183 set.
CDU preflight.
Completed.
Completed. Trim.
6.7 units, 0 and 0.
Taxi and takeoff briefing.
Completed.
Beacon, boat. Before start checklist complete.
Let me just check how I want to taxi here. We're going to do tail left. No. Start sequences 4 and 3, then 2 and 1.
Check.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome on board.
Good day, Captain. The tug is connected now, so we'll be pushing back in just a couple of minutes. Can you please confirm that your parking brake is set?
It is set.
The tug is in position, the bypass is inserted, and we are ready for pushing now. Clear for engine start.
In an emergency, lights will illuminate the aisle. The cabin is pressurized. If there is a loss of cabin pressure, a panel will open and oxygen mask will appear. Remain seated with your seatbelt fastened and pull a mask towards you.
Start engines 4 and 3.
Starting 4 and 3.
The coloring here is a bit odd, not normal, but I mean, I think it can be fixed because FSLAB doesn't have it with the tomato shade, so should definitely be able to be fixed. Yeah. Start engines 1 and 2.
Starting 4 and 3.
Start engines 2 and 1.
Starting 2 and 1.
Pushback is complete. Set your parking brakes, please, and confirm.
Before taxi procedure.
Okay.
Tug is disconnected, captain, and clear. Bypass pin has been removed.
Flaps 10.
Flaps 10.
Clear left and right. Disconnecting now. Have a good flight. Bye-bye.
Yes. Before taxi checklist.
Before taxi checklist. Anti-ice. Auto. Recall. Checked. Auto brake. RTO. Flight controls.
Alright, that's just loading the time, just updating the time. So yeah. It's gonna take a little while. At least it doesn't happen during takeoff, which is good. Rather now than during takeoff. That would definitely suck. Or during landing. Hope it doesn't happen then either.
Check.
Oops. Checked.
Flaps 10 green. Ground equipment.
Clear.
Clear. Before taxi checklist complete.
Clear left side.
Clear right.
The washers work. Before takeoff checklist.
Before takeoff checklist. Flaps.
10. Flaps 10.
Flaps 10. Before takeoff checklist complete.
Runway entry procedure.
Okay.
Maybe this wasn't the best taxiway to take. It was 747. But we'll make it.
I'm ready to go.
takeoff.
Check.
That's fine.
80 knots thrust set.
Checked. The caution is wrong.
Positive rate.
Gear up.
Gear up. Flaps 5. Speed check, flaps 5. Flaps 5 green.
Flaps 1.
Speed check, flaps 1.
Flaps up.
Flaps up. Flaps 1 green.
After takeoff checklist.
After takeoff checklist. Landing gear. Up. Flaps. Up. After takeoff checklist complete. Flaps up.
Flight level 322 is sent for a cruise. We're going to go and proceed direct Yankee Victor November. we're just about breaking the clouds. And a beautiful morning. And as we arrive in Frankfurt, it should also be morning. Absolutely stunning. Set standard.
Transition. Flight level 100. Happy to release the cabin crew.
Yes.
Okay.
I really have the morning vibes. I used to fly long hauls a lot, and always when we departed in the morning, it was always a certain vibe to it, a certain feeling, a certain look, and I really feel it. Like, it's really immersive right now. It's incredible how detailed a parrot can get. Next minute, I think it can be just as good. I don't know, something about prepared just makes, even though it looks a bit cartoonish, I guess you could say, I don't know. In a way, it looks so much better, though. I don't know, it's weird. I've always liked the look of FSX and prepared, if you had the right add-ons and stuff. Especially with prepared now that you can tweak with PTA or tomato shade in this case, and everything. It's just absolutely stunning, and it just looks beautiful, in my opinion. I don't know, I totally love X-Plane graphics too, especially the lights. Lighting system, oh my goodness. Trust me, I started with X-Plane 9, used X-Plane 10, and around X-Plane 10, about the end of the cycle, I started using FSX Team Edition for about a year. Already, in 1 year, I've got like 1,300 hours on it. So I used it a lot. And then I used X-Plane 11 when it came out, and then just recently, about 4 months ago, I switched to prepared 4.5. And so now I'm still here, and I really love it. It's really amazing. And I just have this, right now, this departure just gives me those memories again when I used to fly long hauls all the time as a little kid in the morning, and you would just see the sunrise, and then you just break the clouds, and you see how beautiful the clouds are, how bright they are, and the sky is just a certain color, it looks just like it. Of course, I was flying different airplanes. I was like flying 777 and 767s, not the 748s at the time. But man, the vibes. So damn similar. Good. And also, it could also have an influence that it's now midnight here where I live, so I am tired as well, so that could also have a little effect on it, which is kind of cool still at the same time. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. We'll see you in part 2 when we land in Frankfurt, my original hometown, original home airport. Now I live a little bit more north than that. That means a little bit, about a 5-hour drive. So, yeah. Again, thank you, and any support that you guys can give me, I highly appreciate. Until next video, peace out.